Hey YouTube, Ravi here. In the Feb of 2015, the Raspberry Pi Foundation launched the Raspberry Pi 2. It was launched with an awesome tag of being 6 times faster. With a 9 MHz quad-core Broadcom processor and a GB of RAM, it has well lived up to the hype. The most popular OS for Raspberry Pi is Raspbian, which is the official distribution of Debian Visi operating system for the Raspberry Pi. Let's see how to install it on the Raspberry Pi 2. Though the Raspberry Pi is called one of the cheapest computers, it can't run on its own. It needs a couple of input and output devices. Here's what you will need to set up your Raspberry Pi. A microSD card. 4GB class 4 is the minimum requirement, but using a higher class card is recommended. A keyboard and mouse. I will be using Logitech wireless keyboard and mouse, but most of the wired keyboard and mouse will work just fine. Next up, you'll need a display and a respective cable. All displays with HDMI or RCA input work just fine with the Pi. But if, like me, you want to use a monitor with VGA input, you will have to use a HDMI to VGA converter cable. You'll also need a power adapter. 600 mAh is the minimum requirement, but 1 amp is recommended. Internet connectivity is optional while setting up the Pi, but is required to get the updates. You can either use a LAN cable or a USB Wi-Fi dongle like the one I am using. If you have all these, let's get the microSD card ready. On your PC, go to raspberrypi.org/downloads. From here, download the latest version of Raspbian. It will be a zip file and you will need WinRAR or 7-zip to unzip the image file. Download link for both these softwares will be in the description. While the Raspbian zip is downloading, head over to Google and search for Win32 disk imager. Click on the sourceforge.net link and download the exe file. Install this when it's done downloading. You'll need this to write the Raspbian image to the SD card. When the download is complete, open the Raspbian image with 7-zip or WinRAR and extract the ISO file to any location you wish. Wait for it to extract, it may take a couple of minutes. Now, insert your SD card into the PC. Format it once using the Windows Format tool. To write the image to the SD card, open the Win32 disk imager. Select the correct drive letter for your SD card and select the ISO image file from the location you extracted it to. Remember to close any Windows Explorer windows and any music player that might be running in the background. These programs can lock your SD card and you might not be able to write to it. You can now hit write. Writing the image can take anywhere from 3 to 10 minutes depending on your hardware. After that is complete, you can safely eject the card. Now, to set up your Raspberry Pi, insert your microSD card, plug in your keyboard and mouse, the Ethernet cable or Wi-Fi dongle, and the HDMI or RCA cable. The Raspberry Pi doesn't have a physical power switch, just plugging in the power turns it on. After the first boot is complete, you will be greeted with a configuration tool. You can navigate this menu using the keyboard. The first option is Expand File System. Go ahead and hit enter. This will allocate all of the microSD's card space to the OS. The second option lets you change the default password. We will leave it as it is for now. The third option is boot settings. This lets you choose whether to boot into the desktop environment, scratch, or the command line. Since most of the work on the Raspberry Pi is done through command line, we will leave it to that. The fourth option is internationalization options. This lets you change the keyboard layouts and language. I am gonna go with the defaults for now. If you don't know what overclocking means, then you should not touch the seventh option. Going into the advanced options, you should enable SSH even if you don't know what it is right now. Most of the projects use it and it is a very helpful tool in general since it lets you control all the aspects of your Raspberry Pi without a dedicated display. SPI and I2C are methods of connecting various devices and modules to your Pi. We can leave these options untouched for now. If you have connected external speakers to the 3.5 mm jack, then you can force the audio through that jack with this option. You can navigate to the bottom buttons by using the right or left arrow keys. Exit this menu and select finish and then yes to reboot. If you ever wish to change any of these options later on, you can always come back by running the command sudo raspbconfig in the command line or the terminal. After the reboot is complete, you will be asked for login. The default username is Pi. Type that and hit enter. The password is raspberry. The password would not be visible while typing. This is a security feature in Linux system. You are now successfully running Raspbian. To go to the desktop environment, type startx without space and hit enter. If you had plugged in a LAN cable, then you should be now connected to the net. But if you had plugged in a Wi-Fi dongle, you need to configure your Wi-Fi connection. To do that, click on menu on the upper left hand corner and then on preferences and select Wi-Fi configuration. In the window that pops up, click manage networks and hit scan. A list of available Wi-Fi networks should pop up. Double click on the one that you want to connect to and enter your password in the PSK window. Do note that the at key and the double inverted comma key might be interchanged depending on your keyboard layout. If so, then you can correct this in the internationalization options in the Raspbian config tool. After entering your password, hit connect and you should now be connected to the web. Before you start enjoying all that extra horsepower the Raspberry Pi 2 offers, you should probably update your software. You can do that by typing the following commands into the terminal or the command line. Raspbian is now set up and fully configured, and you are ready to enter the awesome world of Raspberry Pi. Thanks for watching, guys. Check out my instructables for step-by-step instructions. Leave a like if you liked it. Let me know in the comments below what you wanna see next. Subscribe for more.